Okay, who will be translating for His Holiness Karikchandra Swami Maharaj?
Then they don't trust you.
他们不信任你。
It's all happened. I don't remember what we said we were going to do. And people say, oh, I don't remember saying that. Sometimes they don't remember. I was talking to one devotee in India. And he had a business. He made a seat covers with cars. So he said, his customers always want things quick. So he tells them, okay. But he knows he can't do it that fast. Then they get mad. So I told him what I learned in Japan. But it's standard, baby. Promise small and give big. So he said, you tell them if they want it in 3 days, but you know it's going to take 4 or 5 days. Tell them it'll take 6 days. So some people will go somewhere else. Anyway, he came back later, he said, yeah, I did that, and my customers were really happy, because he's always early. He says 6 days, but he gives 5 days, 4 days. Oh, very good, very good. You tell all their friends, and he's very good.
他说需要六天交货，但是五天或者四天就交了，所以那些顾客就到处去给他做宣传，他特别好，非常好。
So today someone asked about expectations.
有人问到了期待。
So she was asking a lot of things. So I gave one verse from Bhagavad Gita.
他问了好多的问题，我讲了一个来自巴格丽特的诗节。第四章。
Yajiksha lava santishto. Be satisfied with whatever comes automatically without much external work.
满足于自动到来的一切，不用特别努力。
So, you find that word quite often, Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam. Yajiksha.
这个词 get rich 啊，不仅在巴格丽特，在圣曼巴格等之中也经常出现。
So it's like offer a little but give more.
有的人他说是一点，但是给的更多。
Expect nothing, then whatever you get, you'll think, oh, this is really good.
你没有任何的期待，但是无论得到什么，你都会觉得非常好。
One big businessman, he was asked, how do I choose a wife to be happy married?
有一个生意人，他就问说：“我怎么才能够选择妻子，这样才能有很美满的婚姻生活？”
So, you know, people think a beautiful woman,
有时候人们选择一个美丽的女人，富有的女人。
There was a song when I was a kid, "Never make a pretty woman you love."
我在小孩的，就是在我的孩提时代，我听过一首歌，说永远不要娶一个漂亮的女人当你的老婆。
So today I like that one.
咱们就像那样。
Pretty woman, she'll never do what you want to do.
因为美丽的女人，她永远不会做你想让她做的事情。
Anyway, he said, find a woman that has no expectations.
无论如何，他说要找到一个没有期待的女人。
She's not thinking that this man is going to give me this and this and that.
她没想着这个男人给我这个，给我那个。
You can never satisfy.
因为那样的人，你永远也满足不了他。
But that applies for ourselves also. You're not expecting anything.Whatever you get, well, oh, this is really good.
如果你没有任何指望，无论你得到什么，你都会觉得哦，这简直是太棒了。
But if we have really big expectations,
但如果我们有太多的期待，
then we're going to be disappointed.
那我们就会一直非常的失望。
That even happens in devotees. They have a wrong idea of what initiation is all about.
这也对于奉献者身上经常发生，他们对于启迪是什么意思也有错误的概念。
That's where we made that the disciple for.
这是为什么我们给大家教授门徒课程?
Because some devotees are expecting like miracles. They get initiated, the guru takes their karma, they never get sick.
有的人他们就觉得起迪会给自己带来奇迹，比如说起迪完了之后，姑姑就会保证他们永远不会生病，在生活之中永远也不会遇到任何的麻烦。
And all the uninitiated devotees will bow down.
起迪的时候的顶拜。
It doesn't happen.
不过事情并不总是如人愿。
You have to know what to expect.
你必须要知道应该指望着什么。
But in general, promote a goodness, which is simple.
善良属性是简单的。
Is not expecting anything in return for whatever you do.
就是无论你做什么，不要有太大的指望。
Of course, you will get something in return, but not expecting it.
当然你会得到一些东西的回报，但是你不要去指望什么。否则就会出于激情属性。
What will I get?
我会得到什么？
If I become life member, I will be able
to. 如果我成为终身会员，我会得到什么好处？
So Prabhupada, you know people are like that, so you offered many things.
爸爸利用他们这种心理，给他们提供很多的东西。
Keep our life simple, not complicated.
我们让自己的生活尽可能变得简单，不要复杂化。
Not making plans for all the wonderful things we're going to accomplish. Just working, doing our duty nicely, happily.
不要去做很庞大的计划，只是好好的去履行我们自己应该履行的职责。
And always speak the truth.
并且总是说真话。
Or don't say anything. But never make up stories.
但永远不要瞎编。
One devotee I was talking to, he said something, and he said, "I would never lie to you."
然后有一个父亲就跟他说话的时候，他说，我永远不会跟你撒谎。
So I was remembering the story Prabhupada told.
我就想起来一个说话给我们讲过的故事。
The thief, he broke in the house.
一个贼，他闯进了一家人。
And he was upstairs.
然后主人在楼上。
Looking for something.
他跑到楼上去找一些东西。
And the people were downstairs, they didn't know. They said, what's that noise?
然后楼底下的人就听到了这种噪音，就说，这是什么？这声音是什么？
So he said, it's okay, I'm not stealing.
然后他说，没事儿，我可没偷。
Simplify our thinking and daily life. We do the same thing every day. You know, chant 16 rounds, get up at the same time, take bath, you know, dress more or less the same. You know, and it's simple.
我们的生活尽可能变得简单。我们在同样的时间起床，然后念诵，然后做就穿着差不多类似的衣服，每天去履行我们应该做的职责。
Okay, so. 还有什么？ So I want to take up some of the points Kavichandra Swami brought up.
我就刚才开篇上嘛所说的话题呢，我就继续来接说。
He spoke about the importance of speaking the truth.
他讲到了说真话的重要性。
So Prabhupada also had he quoted a Sanskrit saying, it says, Satyam Bruyat, Priyam Bruyat. That when you speak the truth, you must make it pleasing.
圣帕巴德就说了这样一句梵文词。
One time the devotees who were publishing the Back to Godhead magazine put in an article which was not liked by some people in India.
有一次呢，奉献者在《回归使者》杂志上刊登一篇文章，那印度的一个人呢，他不喜欢这篇文章。
There was an article taken from the Chaitanya Charitamrita which was about a saintly man, a great, not just a saint, but a guru, an acharya for some other people.
那这篇章是呢，它涉及到了Chaitanya Charitamrita当中的一个事件，那个事件呢是也讲的是其他的人的一个Acharya和Guru。
So the incident was described how this Acharya had met Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and Lord Chaitanya had joked with him and corrected him about something.
这篇章呢是有关于这个Acharya，他遇见的是Chaitanya Mahaprabhu。
So the people, that these people, they were actually devotees of Lord Krishna, but not from our Sampradaya. So some of them were like members, and they were receiving our magazine.
这些人呢，也是主 Krishna 的奉献者，但不是我们Sampradaya，我们始终传信的人。然后这些终身会员呢，他们就。
So when they read the magazine, they were very upset and they complained to Srila Prabhupada. And Prabhupada wrote back to them, he said, I'm sorry, my disciples don't know the etiquette that when you speak the truth, you must make it also pleasing.
然后圣帕巴德就向他们，给他们写信说，我感到非常抱歉，我的门徒们他们不懂礼节。当你说真话的时候，你讲真话的时候呢，应该讲宜人悦人的真话。Sometimes
you know they may say things which may be true, but they can be very disturbing and they can be even insulting to people.
我们有时候说的话虽然是真话。
So we often get this kind of situation among the devotees. We may not like something. We may not appreciate the way something is being done. And we may criticize someone. So the person who is being criticized, they get very upset and they attack the person who is criticizing them.
而那些受到批评的人呢，他们就非常的生气，然后他们就反唇相讥。
And in this way, you get a very tense situation among the devotees.
奉献者们之间呢，这样呢，他们彼此之间关系就非常紧张。
People say nasty things to each other.
他们彼此之间呢，就恶语相向。
Right. It's quite common. So how can we avoid these things? Well, sometimes it's better, even though something may be wrong, you don't like something or something is wrong, sometimes you have to be careful about how you bring it up and who you bring it up to.
有的时候呢，别人可能做的事情确实不对，但是呢，你怎么来说这个事情，而且跟谁说这件事情，你要小心了。
If you go directly to the person who's responsible, they're not going to like you criticizing them.
如果你把这个事件呢，直接就向对方，直截了当的指出来呢，这对方呢，非常会不喜欢你来这样指责他们。
What we have to do, we have to go to somebody who is senior, who is above all these other people, who is like in a managerial position, and you have to go to them and express your doubt or opinion.
我们可以这样去做，就是我们可以把这个事情呢，向上呈现给那些处在管理位置上的人们，这些年长资深的管理者，然后向他们表达我们的疑惑。
Then they can tell you if your criticism is right or not.
他们就可以告诉你，你对这个对方的指责是对的还是错的。
And they can go and take action.
他们接着呢，可以采取行动。
But if we try to do it ourselves, and if we're not in a managerial position, then the person who you're criticizing will not like your criticism.
但是如果我们自己主动的就向对方就直接表达了表达，那么对方呢？ 他们是不喜欢我们这样来指责他们的。
And that person who you criticize, they'll have a grudge against you. That you said these things to me. That person, they said like this to me. And they just have very nasty feelings towards each other.
对方呢，他们就会满腹牢骚。哎呀，这个人他对我就说了这种话，然后这样呢。 这两人之间，他们彼此的感情呢，就会越来越糟糕了。
So it's very difficult dealing with people and bringing up issues which you may not like.
就是对于我们看不惯的这个事情啊，就是怎么来把它提出来，怎么处理这件事情，其实是很棘手的问题。
So we were talking about tolerance, how tolerance is really important.
我们谈到了容忍，容忍是非常重要的。
Lord Chaitanya said, be tolerant like the tree.
如柴丹家说，要像大树一样宽容。And
offer all respects to others.
要向其他人致敬。
And not to be anxious to be respected ourselves.
不渴望别人来尊敬自己。
So this is, of course, this is a very important instruction, and we're not always able to remember this.
这是非常重要的训示，但是我们并不总能想起这条训示。
And when we forget it, then that's when the problems come.
一旦我们忘记了这条训示的话，那么就会有问题出现。
So, Kali Yuga, it's the age of quarrel. It's very easy for us to quarrel and argue with each other.
卡利年代是争吵的年代，我们彼此之间呢意见不合，有纷争，这是非常司空见惯的。
So we do have to be very careful how we deal and what we say to each other.
我们彼此之间如何交往，彼此之间的言谈举止，我们要小心了。
Well, it's true. They did it. It's true. I'm telling the truth.
我们可能说，我说的都是真话，他确实做了这件事，我并没有说瞎话。
But if we say it in a manner which is not pleasing, which they don't like it, you're upset. Then it becomes a big issue.
但是倘若我们说话的方式呢，并不是那么讨人喜欢，或者令人感到内心不安的话，那么这就会造成麻烦了。
So it's very difficult for us, trying to be devotees, trying to work together is the biggest challenge to our Krishna consciousness movement.
所以这对于我们成为奉献者，我们奉献者之间彼此交往，我们保持 Krishna 自觉是一个挑战。
Krishna has given us everything: wonderful philosophy, beautiful temples, wonderful kirtans. We just have to learn how to
work together with each other.
Krishna 给了我们一切，给了我们美妙的哲学，非常漂亮的妙语，给了我们非常好的，但是给了我们美妙的Kirtan。接下来呢，我们的挑战就是彼此之间如何合作相处。
So, Kavi Chandramaraj was speaking about the importance of being truthful, but certain situations require us to be not truthful.
Kavi Chandramaraj 讲了，说真话的重要性，但是在有些情况之下呢，我们也不能什么都说真话。
And Prabhupada writes in one purport how great souls cheat.
圣帕帕德在一个要旨当中说到，伟大的灵魂，他们也会骗人欺骗。Right,
talking about how Vidura and Dhritarashtra and Gandhari, they sneaked out of the house and out of the palace at Hastinapur, and they did not tell Maharaj Yudhisthira.
Dhritarashtra. 还有甘达瑞和维杜拉，他们悄悄地溜出了皇宫，他们并没有向尤迪斯提尔马拉就事先打了招呼就走了。
So Maharaj Yudhisthira was taking care of his uncle, his two uncles. Vidura was also his uncle, and Dhritarashtra was his uncle, and his aunt was Gandhari. So they were elderly people, and he was taking care of them. But suddenly, they're gone, and he didn't know where they've gone.
Yudhisthira Maharaj 非常精心地照料了他的伯母，他的伯母，还有他的叔叔，这些巴士和维多尔，还有甘达瑞，但他们突然之间就找不着他们了。
And then he understood how they had left home without telling him.
后来他就明白了，这些长辈他们突然就不辞而别。
And Maharaj Yudhisthira said, I have been cheated by these great souls.
Maharaj Yudhisthira 就感叹道，我被这些伟大的灵魂欺骗了。
And then Prabhupada explains how great souls will cheat for a great cause.
释迦牟尼佛在要旨当中解释说，伟大的灵魂们会为了更高的一个事业，为了更高的事业而去欺骗。
If you have a great cause, then you're allowed to cheat.
如果你有一个更高的事业，那你就被允许可以去欺骗。
We have examples of great souls who cheated. Sanatana Goswami cheated. He was in the prison house and he cheated to get released from the jail.
Sanatana Goswami 被关在监狱里，他为了获得释放而撒谎。Right,
the jailer. First of all, Sanatana Goswami told him, I'll give you some gold coins, I have a lot of wealth, I'll give to you. And the jailer said, but what will I say? What should I say to the Nawab who has arrested you? What will I say has happened to you?
Sanatana Goswami 就向狱卒忍诺说，我会给你一些金币，只要你要放了我。 但是这个狱卒就说，那我怎么向那瓦侯赛因国王，我怎么向侯赛因国王去汇报呢？And
Sanatana told him, he said, just say, Lord Sanatana said, I want to go to Mecca. I'm going to go on pilgrimage to Mecca to worship the Lord there. So you just tell him that you took me to the Ganga to pass through, and I fell into the Ganga and drowned.
Sanatana Goswami 就跟那狱卒信誓旦旦地说道：“我要去麦加朝圣，所以你只需要向国王呈报，报告说你带我去恒河那里，去那里去，去。”
大便，去大便，然后呢，我就掉到了恒河里，然后就死了。你就这么跟国王说报告就好了。
So he cheated, but he got out of jail, and he went to, he found Lord Chaitanya, and he was able to give the rest of his life in devotional service in the holy Dhamma.
什么都不做犯的，所以他是撒了谎，但是他是为了更高的事业行骗，这样呢，他的余生就可以从事奉爱服务了。
So sometimes you have to lie and cheat.
所以有的时候啊，也得撒点小谎。
But it has to be for the service of Krishna.
但是应当是为了服务 Krishna 而去撒谎。
Maybe conjunctions about when you can lie.
伟达的学士也提到过，什么时候、什么样的情况之下你可以撒谎。
Krishna told Arjuna a story.
Krishna 第二尊讲了一个情况。
Very simple man lived in the jungle community.
有一个非常淳朴的人住在丛林里的一个地方。
And he heard this, the truthfulness is the highest.
他听说。
Truthfulness is the highest.
真诚是最高级的。
So he took a vow, I'll never lie.
于是他就发誓，我永远不会撒谎。
So one day he was sitting, he was all by himself, but one man came running by and just panicking, running by.
他自己坐在那儿，但是有一天突然来了一个人，这个人就是非常惊恐的在奔跑。
And he went down one path.
然后这个人呢就顺着一条路走下去了，就跑下去。
A little bit later, a gang of thieves came and they had knives and they were chasing.
然后过了一段不久之后呢，就来了一帮人，这是一帮盗贼。他们手里拿着刀剑什么的，在追这个人。然后就这些盗贼就问他：“你见过这个人吗？他去了哪条路？”
So he thought, I have to tell the truth. So he said, "I'm not Krishna."
然后他就想，我得说真话。他就手指头指了一下。
So they caught him and they killed him.
然后这些人抓住了那个人，杀了他。
So he got karma.
他得到了 karma.
In that case, he should not tell.
在这种情况下是不应该说真相的，除非是更高的真相。
This is the verse from the Gita chapter 422.
这是《波迦梵歌》第四章第二十二节。
Yad vichya labha santushto dvanda chitya vimacharaha samatsado asado vichya vipapina nivajita. He who is satisfied with gain which comes of its own accord.
一个人他会因为自然到来的得意而满足
free from duality
免于二重性
you mentioned duality but it is hot, cold, happiness and Krishna says we have to be free not controlled by that
我们跟大家提到了二重性冷热苦乐 Krishna 告诉我们说不应该去就是受他们的控制应该免于这些二重性
steady and success and failure
无论是成败都必须非常稳定。
Generally, if we have so-called success, we become very proud.
一般来讲，如果我们得到了我们想要的成功，就会变得很骄傲。
And if we fail, we'll get depressed or blame somebody else.
如果我们失败了，我们就会变得非常的沮丧，并且是责怪别人。
When Balaram was playing a game with Rukmi, and Balaram won, but Rukmi said, "No, I won."
巴拉拉姆跟鲁克米在玩一场游戏，巴拉拉姆赢了，但是鲁克米说不是我赢了。
So if we can be all those things, it's very simple. Never entangled, even though doing things.
这些事情都有提及，就是说，即使你在做事情的时候，也不应该牵涉其中受到纠缠。
Purport.
要旨。
A Krishna conscious person does not make much endeavor to maintain his body.
一个 Krishna 知觉的人不会付出过多的努力来维系自己的躯体。
He's satisfied with gains which are obtained with their own accord.
他会满足自然而然到来的得意。
He neither begs nor borrows.
他既不会偷也不会去借。
He labors honestly as far as his power.
他尽可能去诚实的工作。
And he's satisfied with whatever he gets by his own honest labor.
通过他自己的努力，无论他得到了什么，他都会满足。
He's therefore independent in his livelihood.
因此，他在自己的生计方面是独立的。
He does not allow anyone's service to hamper his own service in Krishna consciousness.
他不会让其他的人去干扰他在 Krishna 知觉之中的服务。
However, for the service of the Lord, he can participate in any kind of action without being disturbed.
然而，如果为了服务主的话，他可以从事任何种类的活动，而且不会受到干扰。
By the duality.
不会受到二重性的干扰。
Duality is felt in terms of heat and cold, misery and happiness.
二重性是苦、乐、冷、热，这样可以体验到。
A Krishna conscious person is above duality.
一个 Krishna 知觉的人超越二重性。
Because he does not hesitate to act in any way.For the satisfaction of
Krishna,
because he does not hesitate to act in any way for the satisfaction of Krishna.
这便是中人知觉的一个原则。
So the mode of goodness we read about food and the mode of goodness, everything.
在善良属性之中，我们吃善良属性之中的食物，我们做的所有的一切都属于善良属性。
Bhagavad Gita has 100 verses about the mode of goodness.
巴格吉特之中有上百个章节谈到物质自然属性。
Because we can't get out if we don't know where we're in.
因为如果我们不知道我们到底身处其中的是什么，我们也不能摆脱。
Know what is the mode of goodness.
我们要了解什么叫自然属性。
Simple living, eat simple, not too sweet, not too hot, not too salty, not too nothing, nice.
简朴的生活就意味着吃的很简单，不要吃的太甜，吃的太辣，吃的太苦，吃太酸。
Play sport for the sake of playing and not for the meaning.
然后呢，如果你去玩耍的话，你是去为了玩而玩，并不一定非得赢。
I saw one very famous basketball player.
我见过一个非常著名的篮球运动员。
And he's kind of admired as a smart person.
他是很多人就仰慕的对象，非常的聪明。
So the reporter said there's two kinds of players.
记者说有两种类型的球员。
Some play, they have to win.
有的人如果是打球必须要赢
and some are afraid to lose.
有的人是打球特别害怕输
so which one are you?
那你属于哪一种
he said neither one.
他说两个都不是
if either way you'll be unhappy.
因为无论是任何一种都会让你不高兴
That's what we're talking
about. 这也就是我们想谈论的
do it for the sake of doing, that's the mode of goodness.
我们只是为做而做，这就是善良属性。努力的尽自己最大的努力，无论你做什么。但是不去期望得到任何荣誉。
Amani Dei Na Amani Dei Kirtaniya Sadhari,
这样我们才可以一直唱诵还有故事。
So like if we are saved, we are saved by chance. We are growing our own food.
比如说，终于有那么一天，我们是自己种自己吃的食物。
That simplifies our diet quite a bit.
就会让我们的饮食非常的简单，
right.
对吧
？You have to eat whatever is coming.
因为你种什么，你就得吃什么。
You have to wait.
你要等待。
Instead of going into the supermarket and have to decide what do I want today, there's so many things.
而不是说你去超市，然后你就很难决定今天我到底应该买什么吃什么。
Or going to a restaurant.
或者是去餐厅，有那么长的菜单，怎么选择
？It's confusing.
就非常令人困惑，非常复杂。
You have to make so many decisions.
因为需要做出很多的决定。
So if we know about the beginning, we know what to do and what not to do in different circumstances.
我们阅读巴格吉特，我们就知道在不同的情况之下应该做什么，不应该做什么。
If we see Krishna in everyone's heart, then we can tolerate different kinds of behavior.
如果我们认识到Krishna在每一个人的内心之中，我们就可以容忍其他人的行为举止。
Understanding that, you know, it's Krishna.
理解到就是Krishna.
He's arranging who we meet, when we meet, and where.
在指导到底是我们需要什么，我们什么时候需要，我们到底应该怎么做。
That's the only way you can really be equal in happiness and distress and success and failure and honor and dishonor, all the things that this world can tell you.
就是唯一能够在苦乐、侮辱、冷热之中能够保持坚韧不拔的办法，这也是 Krishna 一直提到的。
When we do that, it's pleasing to Krishna.
当我们做到了之后，就可以取悦 Krishna。
If you read chapter 12 of the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna will have all the soul.Such a person is very dear to me.
我在读《巴格丽特》第十二章，然后说这样的一个人呢，他非常受到我的真爱，他对所有人都是平等的。
Equal in victory and defeat.
他在成败之中。
Honor and dishonor.
在荣辱之中。
Sometimes in sport.
他们一视同仁，有的时候在运动中。
Someone will win, and they'll say, "I was just lucky. He played a great game, but somehow I wasn't able to."
有的时候有人赢了，但他说：“哎呀，对方其实他们打得特别好，但只不过就是我比较幸运赢了而已。”
And if they lose, they'll say, "Well, he was better."
如果他是
I did bad, I didn't play well.
如果他要是输了的话，他就说还是对方打得好，我没有他发挥那么好。
But some will start shouting at the referee and cursing.
可是有的人他们就会暴跳如雷，还会指责别人。
Referee's wrong.
说我才是那个应该本来应该赢的人。他们的立场其实不好。当我们跟奉献者们一起联谊的时候，我们也努力取悦别人，这样我们也可以取悦 Krishna。可以吗？请问大家有问题吗？任何人都可以问问题，问任何问题。
有没有问题可以提出来？
哈利·库什纳，迪拜咕噜，迪拜大人，就是咕噜，就是这一次。来干嘛？就是来进行。然后这一路上就是看到一些奎什纳的庙，就是奎什纳他是宇宙的源头，他有5000年或者是，就是500年的历史。那为什么那个佛教的庙不是很？佛教2500年之前，为什么佛教的庙很盛行，而奎什纳的庙就是都是很多是新建的，而且就是很少？然后就是我有这个疑问，然后就
Hare Krishna, greetings to Guru. My question is that, during the trip, I saw, although Krishna consciousness is 5,000 years of history, the Buddhism is only 2,500 years of history.I saw many Krishna consciousness temples is very new, and it's not so much Krishna consciousness temple than the Buddhist temple. So I have this question.
Well, you have to understand the Chinese people brought the Buddhist culture, they brought the Buddhist religion here.
你要明白呢，是中国人他们把佛教带到了这里的。
They introduced the Buddhists. They brought Buddha temples. That was what they had been taught. That was their contribution.
就是在马来西亚的华人，他们把佛教带到了马来西亚，这是他们对马来西亚所做的贡献。
Even in India, Buddhism used to be very rampant all over India.
即便是在印度呢，以前呢，佛教很盛行。
If you go to the Mathura Museum, in the Mathura Museum, there's many Buddhas.
你要去马普热的博物馆，就 就会看到在博物馆里有很多佛。
But you won't find Buddha temple.
但是在那里呢，你看你找不到佛庙。
There used to be Buddhism, but practically it was driven out of India.
在以前呢，有佛教，但后来呢，佛教被赶出了印度。
And they brought it into countries like China and again like Sri Lanka, Burma, Malaysia, these countries.
他们后来把佛教呢就传到了中国，缅甸、马来西亚这样的国家。
Because Buddhism is atheistic philosophy.
佛教是无神论的哲学。
So it was accepted by atheistic people.
无神论者会接受佛教。
But in India, there were the acharyas who preached and brought back the culture. You see, the culture was there 5,000 years ago, but in course of time it was lost because the Brahmins became degraded.
就是在5000年前呢，本来是存在着韦达经，后来由于 Brahmana 他们堕落了，所以后来就韦达经就一度被停止了传播。
Brahmanas became materialistic, they became corrupted, and they encouraged people with animal slaughter.
这些朋友们他们堕落了，变成物质主义者，他们后来就屠宰一些动物。
So then Lord Buddha came and he taught the people ahimsa. He taught ahimsa dharma that you should be non-violent, you shouldn't kill anything.
佛祖后来显现就教导了 ahimsa, 教导世人不要去屠宰。
But he didn't teach about the supreme being. He didn't preach that there's a God.
佛祖并没有教导。至尊主、至尊神的存在。
He just said, "You should find out."
佛祖只是说，你们自己去寻找、去探求。
So Buddhism became popular all over India, but then the acharyas came, great acharya like Shankaracharya, and he defeated the Buddhists, and he has brought back the Vedas.
后来佛教就在印度一度就非常盛行。Acharya, 他就在印度显现之后又恢复了韦达经。
As you said, Buddha was 2,500 years ago. Then Shankaracharya came, that was like 1,200 years ago.
所以就像你说的，佛教呢是2500年的历史，但是Shankaracharya。
商
杰罗呢？他是在1200年前，他在印度显现的。
So Shankaracharya drove the Buddhists out of India.
商杰罗就把佛教赶出了印度。
Into the atheistic countries like China.
赶到了无神论国家，像中国这样的无神论国家。
So it came into China about that time, about 1,000 years ago.
所以大约就在1000年前，佛教就进入了中国。
But the acharyas came, more after Shankaracharya, then the other Vaishnava acharyas came, and they established, they brought back the worship of Vishnu, and then Lord Chaitanya came, and he taught the worship of Krishna.
所以在商觉罗之后，又有其他的 acharya 在印度显现。之后，他们又建立了学说。之后，在500年前，主产生的马哈帕布在印度显现了。
So with Lord Chaitanya, he popularized the worship of Krishna, and he also explained that Krishna is worshipped along with his consort, Srimati Radharani.
所以，就是由于产生的马哈帕布，所以 Krishna 直觉呢，就在人们当中变得。普及，主持人的妈阿布又引荐人们去崇拜 Radha 和 Krishna。
So after Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then You know, we have other acharyas come, and then Srila Prabhupada came. Srila Prabhupada brought the message out of India to the Western countries, and the Western countries took it up and spread it around the world.
在财殿拉巴布之后，又有其他的阿查尔们在印度显现，一直到十了帕布塔的，十了帕布塔，Krishna就被带到了西方国家，这样就在全世界就有Krishna就觉得。But
the Krishna had been worshipped for thousands of years, and some of the deities which are worshipped today are thousands of years old.
但是Krishna自觉已经有几千年的历史了。
And you will find the richest culture, the richest philosophy, the richest knowledge, wisdom, spiritual wisdom is there in this culture. The Buddhists, they teach that the absolute truth is zero.
佛教的教义就是说，绝对真理是零。
They don't talk about God. They only talk about Kong.
佛教并不谈神，他们佛教呢，只是一味的说空。
Kong means the void, right? So they don't. When I'm in Taiwan, there's a channel with Buddhist masters, and they've never mentioned God. They never mention about God, they only talk Kong. All you hear is this Kong, the void. So Shankaracharya, he taught the absolute truth is not Kong, it's E. He defeated the Buddhists in this way.
So, 但是商卡扎商杰罗呢，他说，绝对真理是一，所以他就以一就打败了佛教的零。The
Buddhist is teaching, nothing is real. The world is not real. You are not real. Nothing is real. Everything is zero.
佛教就是说，这世界，什么都不是真实的，世界不是真实的，你也不是真实的，一切都是零。
So I'll take a break and beat you on the head. It's not real.
那如果拿根棍子打你的头，那也不是真实的了。Right? 是吗？
This is their fault. It's not a practical philosophy.
所以他的哲学呢，并不是一个实际的哲学。
So Shankaracharya came and thought that actually, nothing is zero, everything is one. You thought everything is Brahman. Shankaracharya brought back the Vedas, defeated the Buddhism, but he just thought the absolute truth is one, everything is one.
Shankaracharya, 他打败了哲学，他又建立了伟达经的权威，但是他教导的说，一切都是一。
And then the other acharyas like Lord Chaitanya came and he thought everything is one and at the same time different.
之后呢，其他的阿查尔，从柴达涅马达布显现之后呢，他说一切都是即一即一。
And then he thought that the conclusion of the Vedic scriptures. You see, there are atheistic philosophies which reject the Vedas. Teachings like Buddhism and Jainism, they're also atheistic.
佛教、基纳教都是无神论的哲学。
But we are following the Vedas. We accept that there is a supreme being. There's a creator behind this world.
但是我们是伟大经的追随者，我们追随的是，就是在这个世界背后呢，有一个创造者。
You have to understand the fact that. Like this microphone, somebody made it. You don't just go and buy it in the shop. Somebody makes it. There are factories where they're made.
所以你必须得承认，我们用的这个麦克风，那一定是有一个创造者，不是我们简单的从商店买来就好了，它会有人制造。
Harmonia, somebody makes them.
我们用的这个 harmonium 琴也一定是有制造商的。
This building, people came and put it up. They constructed this building.
我们这座房子一定是有人来盖起的这个房子。
the city of Penang, some people built it.
槟城是有人盖的槟城。
Can you say it's not real?
你能说这个槟城不是真的吗？
Can you say nobody built it?
你能说没有人盖了这个槟城吗？
No, there's intelligent people who build all these things, get the materials and construct everything.
不是，一定是有智慧的人，他们用了原材料和建了这个槟城。
In the same way, there's a supreme being who creates the whole material world.
同样的，有一个至高无上的生物，他创造了整个的世界。
And from that one supreme being, so many universes come about, and every universe there are so many planets.
从这个至高无上的生物，就有那么多的宇宙从他身体流演出来，之后有那么多的星球。
So, don't judge everything just by big buildings and temples.
所以不要以高楼大厦，以及对庙宇来评判。
You cannot judge the success of some mission just because they have a lot of big temples.
你不能凭借一个使团、一个团体，他们盖了多少的庙宇、豪华庙宇，来判断他的成败。
You have to hear what are they teaching.
你要聆听他们的教导。
You understand?
明白吗？
Historically, one reason that Buddhism became popular.
有一个原因，佛教为什么这么盛行？
Were many Hindu kingdoms.
是因为有很多的印度教的这些国度。
And they were always fighting.
他们总是在打仗，试图去掠夺另外的一个国度。So
the kings were frustrated. So one emperor Ashoka, he was very powerful.
这些国王们也都很困惑，但是终于出现了一个非常强大有力的君主，那便是阿育王。And
he was attracted to Buddha because no violence.
他非常信奉佛祖，因为这是讲究的非暴力。No
fighting.
不要打仗。
Nowadays, inside the Buddhist temples right there, there's lots of fighting in Eastern Japan and Thailand. Who can be in charge?
There's
so much money in being in a place. Anyway, Ashoka was very powerful, so he spread Buddhism all over. People were attracted.
无论如何，阿育王非常强大有力，于是他把佛教传遍了所有的地方，人们也停止了征战。So,
what did she say about Buddhist temples? I don't think in the early days Buddha didn't make temples.
我并不认为在最早的时候佛祖他建了很多的寺庙。
Krishna didn't make temples. He was already Vishnu temple. But Chaitanya didn't make temples. Jesus Christ didn't make churches. He just spread the love of God. He spread the love of God.
He just spread the love of God.
We need temples because it helps us to focus our mind and place where people can come and get some knowledge.
我们需要庙宇，是因为我们需要一个地方，让我们的心意非常的平和，而且可以让人们来得到知识。
We need many.
我们需要很多。
Not necessarily big temples like that, just to make sure you're going to think of such an amazing temple.
我们并不需要很多很多的大庙，然后有一些小的也可以。
But we need many.
我们需要很多。
Temples in the heart.
我们需要很多我们心中的庙宇。
Everybody is keeping Krishna in the heart.
每一个人都要把Krishna留在心中，留在家里。 以我们尽自己最大的努力去传扬，去唱诵圣名。Anyway,
keep it simple.
无论如何，
life simple, not complicated.
让自己的生活保持简单淳朴，不要复杂化。
You know what to do and what not to do according to the scripture.
按照经典，知道应该做什么，不应该做什么。
Therefore, we're stressing read the Bhagavad Gita.
这是为什么我们一直讨论阅读巴格丽的。
Read Prabhupada's Leela.
阅读巴格丽的历史，看他如何跟这么多的人打交道，看他应付了这么多的非常挑战性的情况。
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. And he got information that the price of gold is going to go way up. And somehow we got a lot of other temples to give money to invest in gold. And then Prabhupada heard about it. Prabhupada stopped in Switzerland to meet Chamasundra and go to the bank and watch, you know, the numbers, how the price of everything was going. Then Prabhupada said it's staying the same, sell all the gold.
然后胖胖德说把所有的金子全部卖掉。
Then there were other leaders there, they didn't like this idea of the gold.
但是其他的人他们不太喜欢这个想法。
So Prabhupada told Chamasundra, you go outside.
然后胖胖德说你去外面。
And then he said, this is gambling, no one should do it.
然后胖胖德说这个是赌博，没有人应该做。
Chamasundra was listening. And then Prabhupada said, except Chamasundra, he can do it, because he knows. And then Prabhupada sent him out and brought Chamasundra
in.
And he told Chamasundra, the others don't like it, so don't do it anymore. Sell the gold and food.
其他人不喜欢，也不要再做了，把现在现有的金子全都卖掉。在没有批评任何人的情况下，释迦牟尼佛的教诲。我们读释迦牟尼佛的相声非常的重要，我们有很多的书，还有电影。I think that whole crowd had
It's all translated. Very educational. So the Bhagavad Gita stresses that, you know, if you follow the scriptural injunctions, then everything goes good. And then we want to work towards somehow or other, you know, being more self-sufficient, growing our own food, getting land.
我们想朝着自己自足的这个方向迈进，以得到自己的土地，种自己的食物，然后过一种更自然的生活。
But it begins with this simplifying that however we're living. Don't complicate, you know. Now with this social media, you know, everybody has thousands of friends.
现在随着社交媒体的推广，每个人都会有成千上万的朋友，我们不知道他们在什么地方。
If I send a text,
if I send you a text message, you don't answer right away. Then I think, oh, what's wrong? What's wrong? She doesn't like me. Oh, she's mad at me.
如果我给你发一个信息，结果你不回我，我就会想着怎么回事，是不是出了什么问题了？你是不是不喜欢我？
那个是讨厌的。So we want this instant response for everything. So now we have some musical performance. This is him, Hare Krishna. Thank you very much for your peaceful natures and never arguing with each other and never criticizing each other's devotees.
非常感谢大家平等的选择，不跟彼此，就是彼此之间没有争辩，没有互相的争吵。
Haribo! Even if they're doing wrong,
即使是别人做错了，
if someone is offending me, I should tolerate.
如果有人冒犯我，我应该忍受。
But if they're offended,
但是如果他去冒犯你，冒犯别人，我可以去单独去争取。到时间了，我们现在音乐时间。我们还有在线的课程，线上的课程，单独是。
阿依克什，感恩大家的聆听，顶拜所有聚会的奉献者。